Good morning, my Sudley family. This is Nick and Terry checking in. We're all fine and hoping you're all fine. Looking forward to be with my Sudley family at Sudley Church real soon. God bless and have a wonderful day. And if you're wondering where Terry is, she's holding the camera. God bless.
Good morning, everyone. This is Ellen Purdy, and I'd like to welcome you to Sudley United Methodist Church online Sudley service. First, let's do a Sudley check-in with Bob Reed and Katie Mills.
Sitting here tonight, but reminds me I already have more than I should. I don't need faith, no one to know my name. At the end of the day, Lord, I pray I have a life that's good. Two arms around me, heaven around me, and a family that always calls me home. Four wheels together, enough love to share, and a sweet, sweet, sweet song. At the end of the day, Lord, I pray, I have a life that's good. Sometimes I'm hard on me, when dreams don't come easy, I wanna look back and say, I did all that I could. At the end of the day, Lord, I pray, I have a life that's good. Two arms around me, heaven around me, and a family that always calls me. Four wheels together, enough love to share, and a sweet, sweet, sweet song. At the end of the day, Lord, I pray, I have a life that's good. At the end of the day, Lord, I pray, I have a life that's good.
So as part of our welcome, I do want to give you a brief message from the Purdy family. So Jeff and myself, we are feeling continually blessed, but I must admit, we do miss seeing every one of you in person, and we're looking forward to when we can all get back to Sudley Church together and look each other directly in the eye. But in the meantime, I do feel very, very grateful to all of the people who spend an awful lot of time putting these video together so that we can all worship together through our online services. Hi there. So now let me go through our announcements for this Sunday. On May 31st, that's going to be a special Sunday service for us because that's when we're going to celebrate our graduates. Join us on Sunday at 10:30 as we give thanks to God and honor our graduates with a special service. These graduates didn't get to walk in a graduation ceremony, but we're going to make sure that they're celebrated. Paul Street is going to be bringing the message that day. On June 1st, the Council on Ministries is going to have a meeting through Zoom, and it will be from 7 to 8 p.m. If you have any questions or are interested in participating, please contact Jack Messer. Jack can be contacted through his email address, jack.w.messer@gmail.com. So with Sudley, we try to make sure we stay connected. We have several ways to support our ministry. For worship, we are always here on Sundays at 10:30 in the morning. And we have an ability to grow through adult special growth study via Zoom. And for that, you can contact Debbie Murschell. You can find Sudley updates on our Sudley Facebook page. And we ask that you continue to try to connect to serve everybody that's part of this congregation. We ask that you try to call at least three people. Ask them questions. Check in with them. See how they're doing. Listen to what they have to say. Ask if they have any special prayer requests, and then offer to pray with them. This really does mean a whole lot, and this does help keep everybody connected, and it does bring a special blessing to them. We continue to thank you for all your generosity. You've been very great about continuing with your gifts and your tithing, and you can continue to do that so that we can support our Sunday ministry. You can find the link in order to be able to give online on the Sudley Methodist Church page.
Thank you, Ellen, so much for giving us the announcements. Our opening prayer today is number 556 in the hymnal, which is for Christian unity. I'm going to read it, and then the bold parts, would you join me in reading it as well? Let us ask the Lord to strengthen in all Christians' faith in Christ, the Savior of the world. Listen to us, O Lord. Let us ask the Lord to sustain and guide Christians with his gifts along the way to full unity. Listen to us, O Lord. Let us ask the Lord for the gift of unity and peace for the world. Listen to us, O Lord. Let us pray. We ask you, O Lord, for the gifts of your Spirit. Enable us to penetrate the depth of the whole truth and grant that we may share with others the goods you have put at our disposal. Teach us to overcome divisions. Send us your Spirit to lead to full unity, your sons and daughters in full charity, in obedience to your will, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Jesus, Lamb of God. Good morning, everyone. Just look at all of these pencils. There are short pencils, long pencils, skinny pencils. They're all different colors. They're yellow, red, black, blue. There are many different shapes and sizes and colors of pencils. But there is one thing that all of these pencils have in common. Can you guys guess what it is? The eraser is worn off of every one of them. Do you know what that tells me? It tells me that I make a lot of mistakes. When I make a mistake, I erase it and start over and over again until I get it right. I don't know why I keep these pencils, because as many mistakes as I make, a pencil without an eraser is pretty useless. These pencils remind me of people. People come in all different sizes, shapes, and colors too, but we all have one thing in common. We all make mistakes. We make a lot of mistakes. That is why God sent Jesus to die on the cross, to erase our mistakes. When we do something wrong, we can ask God to forgive us, and because of Jesus, He will erase our mistakes, and we can start over and over again. Unlike these pencils, God's eraser never wears out. Just as God forgives us over and over again, Jesus taught us that we should forgive other people over and over again. What do you guys think about that? One day, Peter asked Jesus, "How many times should I forgive someone who sins against me? Should I forgive him seven times?" I imagine that Peter was pretty proud of himself for being willing to forgive someone seven times. Jesus answered, not seven times, but 77 times. I think Jesus knew that if he said we should forgive 77 times, we would never be able to count, and we would forgive over and over again, just as he forgives us. It doesn't matter if we're short or tall, skinny or fat, blue, pink, yellow, green. We all need God's forgiveness. We also need to remember that Jesus taught us that we are to forgive others just as God forgives us. How about we pray about that? Dear Father, we all sin and fall short. Thank you for sending Jesus to forgive us of our sins. Help us to forgive others the same way over and over again. In Jesus' name we pray.
For our prayers and praises, we want to pray a prayer of thanksgiving. God has given us so many things in this season to be thankful for. And while many are fearful during this time, when you know Christ, you have nothing to fear. So, I want to just join with you in praying a prayer of thanksgiving to God for the many blessings that may be going on in your life, and I know is going on in mine. Would you pray with me? Heavenly Father, we come together this morning just to thank you so much for how much you love us, for how you died on the cross so that we could live. Thank you for taking our place. Lord, today we are alive because you said we could be alive. You breathe your life in us every day, and we live and do your will. God, thank you for keeping us healthy. Thank you for blessing those of us who need to see your face. And God, I just pray that you would touch our lives. Thank you that we can be an example to what it looks like to be like Jesus in the 21st century. We love you, Lord. We, the church, want to be your hands and feet. And now, would you join me in praying the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples? Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever. Amen.
Our scripture reading for today is in 1 John chapter 3, verses 23 and 24. It reads, "And this is his commandment, that we should believe in the name of his Son Jesus Christ and love one another, just as he has commanded us. All who obey his commandments abide in him, and he abides in them. And by this we know that he abides in us by the Spirit that he has given us. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Today, we will finish up our sermon series, Rethink Church. As we think about this topic, through today's reading, the Bible clearly tells us in 1 John 23, love one another just as he, God, commanded us. See, loving one another, it is very important how we understand and perceive that and practice that. If we just make it up, this is what I think love means, and doing it the way what I think right and what it means, it could have very serious negative harming consequences. However, if we've done it as Christ taught us, as God commanded us, and there are wonderful God's promises and blessings. In fact, through my ministry, I have seen the casualties and terrible things happening. Some people, even with passionate eagerness, they claim that they love God and they're doing that because they love God and love other people. And as a result of that, I've seen lots of people being harmed, even being killed, spiritually speaking. However, I've seen many other positive examples when Christians, they humble themselves and themselves under the Word of God and study the Word of God and learn how to love just as Christ taught them. And then I witness that they are blessed and people around them are blessed. So today, we'll hear God's Word so that we can know how we may love one another, not just as I think the way it is, what I think, the way we should be doing, but just as. Would you say this word with me? Just as God commanded us. So go with me to 1 John chapter 3. Verse 23 and 24, it says, and this is his, who's God's commandment, that we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another just as he, Christ, has commanded us. First, loving just as Christ has commanded us, it means that we love those people who hurt us. How'd you like it? Christian loving means we are loving those people who hurt us, who angered us. We forgive because it is God's command, and also we love and forgive because it has immediate and serious consequences with them. Hating other brothers or sisters in God's family, in the context of a church, while we are claiming ourselves as Christians, that may seem harmless in our own eyes. We may say, oh, that's okay, it's not going to hurt anyone. But here's the thing, friends, in the eyes of God, that is the same as committing first-degree manslaughter. It's intentional killing of another human being. Therefore, it is not coming from God, but scripture says that's coming from the evil one. And another part of scripture says, if we do this along with committing adultery and other terrible sins, we will not inherit the kingdom of God. As I hear those words, I get to tremble. Imagine that one day I brought a kind of piece of a newspaper. One day you were reading the newspaper, and then on the top of the newspaper headline, there was your name under the title, so-and-so has committed murder and charged with murder. If that were to happen to you, how would you take that? Wouldn't you be surprised and also devastated? I would. When a person is charged with a murder, it may have lifetime consequences. However, may I say this to you, brothers and sisters, to us Christ followers, it has eternal consequences. Then, brothers and sisters, based upon today's God's teaching, how can we say in the sanctuary here and also in the fellowship hall, in the kitchen, on the hallways, in the choir room and Sunday schools, in the parking lot, without thinking, as if it means nothing, we quickly and easily say, I hate so-and-so, so-and-so hate you, and things like that. We get angry, our faces turn red, then we raise our voices and belittle other brothers and sisters for whom Christ died for. Because someone disagreed with you in a meeting, because you didn't get your way in the budget planning, because some decisions are made while you were away on vacation, or all because someone said that to you or to your face, or someone sent that angry email to you. We do all these things thinking it's not going to hurt anyone, but the Word of God says that is very serious. We need to rethink it. We need to stop doing it. And here's a better way, Christian way. This is the way God told us to follow. So second, loving just as Christ commanded us, it means that we love others without buts, ifs, or when. Moreover, we Christians, we pray for those who harmed us, even we bless them. Some hold grudge against others for a long time. They hold grudge against our brother or sister about things happened some 3 years ago, 5 years ago, and then 10 or some even longer years ago. But that, well, you know, you don't know the whole story. Or others say, you know, the history, there's a history behind it. You don't know what my father did it to me when I was a little girl. You don't know, you don't know, you don't know. In God's book, friends, it doesn't matter. Remember this, God who forgave all our sins, not just minor ones, all our sins, expects us and commands us to forgive and love everyone. I heard people say, you know, Pastor, three strikes out means that if someone did the wrong or harm to you or to us, we kind of tend to count, and you did that once, twice, and three times, and then we tend to say, that's it. You know what, friends? That's how the world thinks and operates, but not so with us. Because, remember, Jesus told us when Peter approached him, Master, how many times should I forgive my brothers? Seven times? What did Jesus say? 70 times seven. So would you remember and also obey this Christ's command? In Matthew 5:43 and 44, Jesus said, you have heard that it was said, love your neighbor and hate your enemy, but I tell you, love your enemy and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be sons and daughters of your heavenly Father. And I have to admit and confess that even as a pastor seeking to follow Christ, there are times I have some challenges, have difficult times in forgiving others. There are times, you know, I don't want to do it. I want to almost scream and say, that's it, I had enough. And I don't want to do this anymore. I don't want to forgive. Even also, I remember Paul gave advice in Titus 3, 9 and the following. Here it is. Avoid foolish controversies and genealogies and argument and quarrels, because these things are pointless and worthless. Reject a divisive man after a first and second admonition. You know, I know this scripture, so, you know, with this and using that as a crutch, I don't want to forgive. I want to say no. Then I remember how Christ has loved us and forgiven us. Remember in John chapter 13, verse 34, there Jesus told us, I love one another. Before that, he washed the feet of the disciples, including Judas. Whenever I remember that act of love done by our Lord Jesus Christ, I can't refuse to forgive. Third way of loving, just as Christ had loved us, it means that we love others by meeting their practical needs, the needs of our brothers and sisters. Verse 17 says, how does God's love abide in anyone who has the world's goods and sees a brother or sister in need and yet refuses help? When the sick came to Jesus, Jesus didn't say, oh, I feel sorry about you. I hope that you feel better. He didn't send those people just like that. No, he took them and touched them, embraced them and held them and healed them and sent them home as a whole person. When people were hungry in the wilderness, remember, Jesus didn't say, I know you're hungry, but just I hope that you go and find some food out somewhere there. No, Jesus, he took the 5 bread and 2 fish and blessed and satisfied their hunger. When people were harassed and tired, he comforted them. Remember, he comforted them saying that, come to me, all you who are weary and heavy burdened, I will give you rest. When I was a junior in college, it was 1985. It seems like a long time ago. My alma mater college in Korea celebrated its 100-year anniversary. In the mid 1800s, Methodist and Presbyterian missionaries came to Korea and spread the gospel, and hear this, and they built many schools and colleges and hospitals. My alma mater therefore started 1885, and it is one of the best universities in Korea. Of course, I'm proud of it. And also, it has the best hospital in Korea, almost in Asia as well. Here's the thing. While the first missionaries, as they were proclaiming Christ, they proclaimed Christ through their words, through their lips, but at the same time, through their actions by building colleges and hospitals. Through actions, they spread the gospel. That's why today so many people believe Christ in Korea. And I thank you, and I'm proud of you as your pastor, to you, Sudley congregation. Credit goes to Joyce Kennison, our mission chair, and Bobby Marshall's Bible study class. One Sunday, as we were studying Bible study through Zoom, we learned about God's amazing grace, God's great grace given to us freely. And after we talked about that, the next question was, then how can we express and show this love to others in the world? So we get to talk about how about we start collecting foods and help people who have need in this coronavirus challenge. Then after that, with the leadership of Joyce and also mission committee and people like Marsha and Loretta, and many of you participated, every Sunday from 12 to 2, we fill the cars, sometimes plural, full with food, diapers, and also feminine items. Let's continue showing love to others through our words, but by actions, by meeting their needs. Then the world will know that God is real and God really loves them. So friends, today we heard through God's word, we know that we are loved children of God. That's who we are. How we get to that? Because Jesus Christ, the Son of God, living behind the heaven, came to this world because he laid down his life for us. We are saved not by gold and silver, any jewelry, not any of those, but by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. He paid for our sins. That's how much we are loved. And because of that love, you know what we do? This is who we are. We forgive, we love. We show love to others. We do forgive, we bless our people. We never say, I hate you. Those words do not belong to us. It does not, those words do not fit us as Christ followers. Instead of saying, I hate you, we say therefore, leaning on the power of the Holy Spirit, I forgive you and I love you. I pray for you and I bless you. Those are our words. You may say, thank you, Pastor. And what's the good news for us? Thank you for teaching us about love. Just as Christ loved us, loving one another. I think I got a few things I learned new. But if you obey God, then what should we expect that to happen to us? There are two great blessings, promises coming from God. First is... First good news is, if we listen to this and take this to our heart and start obeying God, our prayers will be answered. Verse 21 says, Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have boldness before God, and we, hear this, receive from Him whatever we ask because we obey His commandments and do what pleases Him. You know, some says to me, Pastor, I don't think God ever answers my prayer. I prayed and prayed, but you know, I don't have God answering my prayers. But at the same time, I have plenty of people with excitement sharing with me, Pastor, I'm so excited. I have to share this. I'd like to share this. I prayed about this and God answered me. It's awesome and amazing. You know, what makes the difference? If we listen the word of God and take it to our heart, and though it is not easy, we practice this Christian love of forgiving and blessing and caring people, God will surely answer our prayers. Next wonderful blessing and promises of God, the good news is, you and I, we will live in the abiding presence of God daily. How'd you like that? Verse 24 says, all who obey His commandments abide in Him, and He abides in them. And by this we know that He abides in us by the Spirit that He has given us. This week, in my fellowship with other clergy, we shared our prayers and praises. What people go through today and nowadays, it's just unbelievable. Two pastors' children lost their jobs. So my clergy friends were asking for prayers. A pastor's grown-up child married about 2 years ago. The spouse told her that he doesn't want to be in the marriage relationship anymore. How about that? And one person is a friend with the coronavirus, a dear friend, thought that he was dying. There's no chance for him to survive, but he's improving. We praise God for that together. One husband had to take his wife out to the hospital because of a certain pain that his wife was experiencing. The sad thing is, yes, he was able to take her to the hospital, but he could not go inside the room and be with her. He had to wait in the parking lot. Forgive me for saying this. Isn't that crazy? Yet, in all those challenges, as we were sharing our challenges and prayers, I could feel and sense there was clear atmosphere and assurance of thankfulness, and Christ's abiding presence was binding us together. Even through Zoom, I could feel it. When we love God and love others and forgive and bless and pray for them, we live in God's best blessings. God will answer our prayers, and we get to live in God's amazing abiding presence every day. I hope that you all, as Christ followers, choose to love and forgive, choose to bless and pray for those people who hurt you, and put that into practice at home, in your neighbors, at work, and also in this church. If you travel for Memorial Day, be safe and have a blessed week, and I will see you next week. Blessings.
Dear brothers and sisters, God said, we are God's beloved children because Christ has laid down his life for us, because Christ has forgiven all our sins, and because Christ abides in us through the Holy Spirit always. So go into the world and shine God's love to your family, to your friends and neighbors, even to the strangers. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.